Well, this is going to be my corn, squash, tomatoes, and melon garden. I get that hutch out of there. Tim is going to be dragging this with the back blade of the tractor and smoothing things out. Of course, this is all the compost that we dumped in here. Holds water, obviously, and it was the pig's wallow for a while. He's going to try to be smoothing that out. We'll be adding some more compost. Oh, you can't see it, but it's behind there is an old pile of horse manure that's been sitting there for a year or 2 years now. And that'll be dumped in here, plus whatever else we can get from the paddock. Then we'll hopefully till it all in, and then we can get to planting. And I was going to put up a couple of these stock panels out here and put my tomatoes on them. But Tim said, well, since we've got stock panels around the perimeter, why don't you just plant your tomatoes against the perimeter stock panels? And I thought, oh, duh. So I'm going to rearrange my garden from what I was thinking in my head and just plant my tomatoes right along there. And the corn will be at this end, probably kind of over this way. And then down right over there will be squash and melon mounds. So, and then this area, I was going to fence off part of this for the pig, the little pigs up in the barn. And I can't decide if I want to do that or not, so I'm still thinking on that. Lena also wants a little garden area, 10 by 12, 12 by 12, something like that. And so I've got to fit that back in here too. And so I'm still feeling a little under the gun and behind because I don't have these things in back here. But as long as I get it by June 15th, June 7th would be better. We can still get a viable garden. And of course, we got to get the other six boxes back here and filled. They're going to go along here, close to the water. And that's where our green beans, I forget what else is going to go in there. Wax beans, green beans, some other stuff. So get those in, and then I'll have everything done. And like I said, I'm hoping to get to that this week. Weather permitting, it's going to rain. And I still don't have all the pasture brush hogged. Never-ending list. Just in case folks are wondering, that might be new to my channel, the water supply we have back here is a little, it's either 1.5 or 2 inch well that my husband actually pounded down. It's a shallow well. And we have had a hand pump on it. And now we have this little gas-powered pump that works like a charm. And this is going to allow me to water my garden and also the pigs. And see the proximity? It's really easy to water the pigs now. And we just cover, or I just cover it up with a barrel when I'm not using it so it doesn't get rained on. And it works really well. If you have a high water table on your property, and that would be where the water sits in your well, a static water level, they call it, at 23 feet or higher, you can put a simple little hand pump on there and pump water. You can also get more heavy-duty industrial-type hand pumps that will lift water from a deeper level. If you want to invest the money, they're kind of expensive. But for shallow wells, 23 feet or higher, static water level, you can put your own well down. And this one has been in a few years now. I do have a video up. Actually, we had one over there too, somewhere over there. We took that one out. I forget why. Probably because it was going to be in the way, but we left this one. Didn't really need two back here. But in Michigan, we're very fortunate. We have water everywhere. My dad was a water well driller. He was a part-time farmer. Well, he was a full-time farmer and full-time well driller. And I can remember, and he started when he was like a teenager because his dad was a well driller. And maybe in that 40-year career, because he didn't retire till he was well into his 60s, maybe one or two wells he couldn't get water on. Maybe. For the most part, he always could get water. Now, sometimes it was 400 feet down, and sometimes it wasn't a real well, a good producing well, or the water wasn't real high quality, but he always could get water, and that's the benefit of living in Michigan. We have a lot of water, and you just dumped yours. You're a naughty pig. I tried to make him a wallow over there, but obviously he's not satisfied, and the water already left it. You can't do that. You're going to get thirsty. I really need to get some kind of nipple situation, you know, with a little barrel or something like that, but I haven't done it. I'm going to have to start the pump again and fill your water. They make me so mad sometimes. He's the naughty one. She doesn't do it. He does it. Yeah, see, she wanted to drink, and you dumped it. So anyway, that's our water supply back here. And putting down a well point is really quite easy, a shallow well point. Go to that video if you're interested. Just search on my channel, putting down a well, and you'll find that video. And it's way easier than people think. There might be some zoning restrictions where you are. Check into that. In our township, there isn't. But do check into that, or put it in a place where nobody's going to see it. I'm not big on zoning and all that business regulations, but okay, gotta fill this up again, little turds.